Good morning, everyone. We're continuing here in the words of the Mesillas, Yesharim. The Ramchal will begin to describe today from the psukim, the verses that we have throughout Tanakh, how we know this obligation to have what's called Yiras Chet, the fear of sin. V'al Yira Zois Amar Moshe ben Amoshal. Moshe ben himself spoke about this in the Torah when he said the following: U'ba'avor tiyeh yirasay al peneichem levilti sechetohu. The reason that HaKadosh Baruch Hu made such an incredible experience by Har Sinai, where the mountain was held over our heads and there was thunder and there was lightning and the sound of the shofar was blasting and the earth was trembling and Klal Yisrael was filled with fear at that moment. Why did HaKadosh Baruch Hu make it such an awesome experience? The reason is, as it says in the verse, in order that this fear, this awe is going to be upon your faces, and you will not sin. As long as Maimon HaSinai is on you, as long as the fear that you have, the awe, the reverence of the greatness of HaKadosh Baruch Hu is on your face, is constantly in front of you, then a person will not stumble into sin, because the awareness of the Ribbono Shel Olam and his desires for us, what he wants us to accomplish and to achieve, how he'd like us to be connected to his Torah and not to trample and transgress what it says, that will hold us back from doing sin. Ki ze ikar hayira. This is the main aspect of yira, of fear. What is that? She adam yare umizlazei tamid. A person should fear, and they should tremble constantly, says the Mesillas Yesharim, in order that they should not do sin. And when they reach a certain point where the fear, the awe, the reverence, and that trembling that comes with that is constant within them, it will never leave. Certainly then, a person will not stumble into sin at that point in their life, because they'll have total, what would seem to be total control over their whims, over their actions, over their desires, over their lusts, over their shortcomings. They'll have control over it because they're always thinking to themselves, if I do the wrong thing, I'm going to sin, and HaKadosh Baruch Hu is too kind and too merciful and too gracious to me for me to sin against the glory of Hashem. And if by chance such a person would end up sinning, how did a person who's constantly walking around with that yira inside of them, how'd they sin? Says the Ramchal, it's considered for them an oynes. It is beyond their control. It is against their will. They never in a million years would have sinned. How did they sin? Something must have happened that pushed them into the wrong direction, because they in fact would never have done that themselves. And the Ramchal continues, V'yishiyohu Omar ben Nevuasa. Yeshaya the Navi writes in his prophecies, V'elzer Abit, says HaKadosh Baruch Hu, I look down at the heavens and the earth, and this is what I'm looking at. El Oni u'necheruach, a poor man, and someone that is necheruach, that is broken spirit, V'chared al dvarai, and someone that fears and trembles regarding my word. He trembles over the words of the Torah. He trembles. He's in fright of doing the wrong thing. Zokta Ramchal, so you see from Yeshaya that this is something that HaKadosh Baruch Hu desires. HaKadosh Baruch Hu appreciates. HaKadosh Baruch Hu looks down on such a person, looks towards that person, and he says, L'kach niver, that's why you were put into this world, to be a person that will tremble in my presence and they will fear from doing sin. King David himself praises himself, not in haughtiness, but he wants HaKadosh Baruch Hu to know just how much his fear and his reverence of him is. As he writes, Sarim radafuni chinam, princes are pursuing me, they're chasing after me for no reason. Dovid HaMelech was haunted by enemies in his lifetime. Everywhere that he turned, every place that he went, there was another enemy that was lurking in the dark around the corner. And they were princes, and they were kings, and they were leaders of world countries and civilizations. His own children in his house rose up against him. And Dovid HaMelech was constantly being pursued by his enemies. Nevertheless, he says, all of that, it's for naught. It's empty chasing and pursuits. Umidvarcha pachad libi. But your word, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the words of Torah, which I'm supposed to keep and uphold to the best of my abilities, that, pachad libi, that my heart trembles and my heart fears. I'm not afraid of my enemies, what they're going to try to do to me. I trust in you, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, you will protect me. However, when it comes to sin, that's up to me if I'll protect myself or not. And that, pachad libi, my heart trembles, my heart, it churns inside of me to make sure that I'm not going to trample and stumble into sinful behavior in order that I can do what is right in your eyes. And we just have to point out what we mentioned yesterday. Although it's talking about trembling, and it's talking about living in some type of fear, chalila, a person should not think that this means that we should walk around anxious and nervous and walking on eggshells all day long. HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants us to be calm and relaxed. Darche darche noyam, the pathways of the Torah are pleasant. V'chol nesivoseya shalom, and every single avenue that you're going to take leads to peace. That means Yiras Shemayim also must be pleasant and peaceful. And therefore, the trembling is an inner trembling of awe and reverence that we have before HaKadosh Baruch Hu, which is an appreciation and a recognition of HaKadosh Baruch Hu and His greatness that will prevent us from stumbling into sin. Have a wonderful day.